Hello viewers, today I am going to talk about the biography and the great contribution of Pandit V.N. Bhatkhande towards Hindustani music. Pandit V.N. Bhatkhande, whose full name is Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande, the great Indian musicologist, has engraved his name forever on the hearts of entire music world for popularizing and systematizing of Hindustani music, reconciling its theory and practice, collecting traditional music compositions of various gharanas and making these available to the entire music world in the written form. Not only this, he brought a renaissance in music education system by imparting music education in music institutions established by himself. It will be no exaggeration if we say that the credit goes to him only to establish new Hindustani Sangeet Padhati. Without his work, no musical revival in the country would have been possible. Pandit Bhatkhande dedicated his entire life for the cause of music. To have a better understanding, Bhatkhande's life and work can be studied under four stages. The first stage consisted of his early life, his musical training, and his own preparation period. Pandit Bhatkhande was born on August 10, 1860 in Balkeshwar, Bombay, now known as Mumbai, on the auspicious day of Krishna Janmashtami, to the father Pandit Narayan Rao, who was a great music lover. Gajanan, as Pandit Bhatkhande was called in his childhood, was gifted with rare music talent, intense love for art, and remarkably shrewd brain. Along with his academic studies, Pandit Bhatkhande learned flute, sitar, and vocal music from very eminent gurus. He learned sitar from Vallabhdas Damulji, and vocal music from Raoji Bua Bel Bakar, a Dhrupad singer, Ali Hussain Khan and Vilayat Hussain Khan, both Khayal singers, and others. Pandit Bhatkhande graduated with a degree in law in 1885. He joined legal profession in 1887 in Karachi High Court and became a successful lawyer. But his legal career was very short. After the death of his young wife and the only daughter, he gave up law practice. From this period starts the journey of Pandit Bhatkhande's ceaseless service for music. He became a member of Gayan Utejak Mandali, a music circle in Bombay. The next stage in Pandit Bhatkhande's life was a period of preparation for the deep study and research in music. For this purpose, Pandit Bhatkhande traveled throughout India, meeting and discussing with many ustads and pandits of various gharanas. He visited all the important music libraries, studied the ancient texts like Natyashastra and Sangeet Ratnakar, and occasionally delivered lectures on music in Gayan Utejak Mandali, whose he was a member. He devoted nearly 15 years to study all the available music literature in Sanskrit, Telugu, Bengali, Gujarati, Urdu, and English. During his extensive touring for the purpose of musical research and study, he spent time in Baroda, Gwalior, and Rampur. He got training in the various styles of classical music like Dhrupad, Dhamar, and Khyal, etc. Listened to the great ustads and noted down their compositions tactfully. It is not irrelevant to mention here that in those days, listening to great ustads was strictly forbidden by them, except for their own disciples. Panditji somehow managed to collect very rare compositions, notated those, and later on published those in the form of books. He collected more than 300 precious compositions, especially of Manrang Gharana, from Ustad Muhammad Ali Khan, Asghar Ali Khan, and Ahmad Ali Khan of Jaipur. Along with these, he composed several bandishes of his own under the pseudonym Chatur Pandit and Vishnu Sharma. He wrote all these bandish or musical compositions in his self-developed notation system, about which I will talk later on. After deep study in music and getting practical training, Pandit Bhatkhande realized that there are differences of opinions in regard to the various subjects of music, and there is a gulf between theory and practice also. He felt an all-round progress of music is not possible until and unless reconciling its theory and practice. After pondering over the matter, he came to the conclusion that some rules may be framed with the consent of all the musicians for systematizing Hindustani music and coordination of its theory and practice. For this purpose, he adopted the idea of musical conferences. Pandit Bhatkhande is called the father of musical conferences. He organized 5 consecutive All India Music Conferences held in Baroda in 1916, 2nd held in Delhi in 1918, Banaras, now called Varanasi, in 1919, and twice in Lucknow in the year 1924 and 1925. The aim behind organizing these conferences was to provide a common platform for the musicians and musicologists from North and South to listen to one another, discuss, and come to an agreement on the disputed aspects of music. These conferences proved very fruitful for the classical music and thus for realizing Pandit Bhatkhande's dream true. Now let's have a look on the contribution of Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande. As I have said earlier, Pandit Bhatkhande devoted his entire life in systematizing of Hindustani music, music education, publishing books on music, developing notation system, collecting the traditional musical composition, as well as making the compositions himself, and so on. Now let's have a brief look on all these aspects. Pandit Bhatkhande authored a number of books in Sanskrit, Marathi, Hindi, and English. His first published work was Swarmalika, a booklet containing detailed descriptions of all the prevalent ragas in Gujarati. Now the Hindi translation of this book is available. In 1909, he published Shrimal Lakshya Sangeetam in Sanskrit. This book may be called the torchbearer of Hindustani music. You can see the photograph of Hindi translation of this book. In 1910, Pandit Bhatkhande published his book Hindustani Sangeet Padhati in Marathi, and over a span of several years published 4 volumes of this book. Through this book, he made cultural heritage accessible to the common man by publishing commentary of his own Sanskrit granths in Marathi. These volumes form today the standard text of Hindustani music. The precious practical compositions which he managed to collect from great ustads and pandits of various gharanas, notated those in his self-developed notation system and published in the form of book named Hindustani Sangeet Padhati Kramik Pustik Malika in Marathi in 6 volumes. In all the 6 volumes of this book, there are 1892 musical compositions of Dhrupad, Dhamar, Khayal, Sadra, Trana, Chaturang, and Lakshan Geets, etc. in 181 ragas written in Bhatkhande's notation system. Note, unnecessary to mention here that there are 30 compositions in part 1, 329 in part 2, 513 in part 3, 531 in part 4, 252 in part 5, and 237 compositions in part 6. The first four parts of these books were written and published in the year 1919, 1921, 1922, and 1923 consecutively. The fifth and the sixth parts, however, were written in 1929 and 1931, yet were published in 1937 after the death of Pandit Bhatkhande in 1936. This book may be called the storehouse of Hindustani ragas. Except these books, he wrote Ashtotrshatal Lakshanam and Abhinav Ragamanjari in Sanskrit, Lakshan Geet Sangraha, Swar Malika Sangraha and Geet Malika in Hindi, and a short historical survey of the music of Upper India and a comparative study of some of the leading music systems of the 15th, 16th, 17th and 18th centuries in English. The Hindi translation of both of these books have been published by Sangeet Karyalaya Hathras, UP in the name of Uttar Bhartiya Sangeet ka Sankshipt Itihas and Sangeet Paddhatiyon ka Tulnatmak Adhyan. Except from his self-written books, Pandit Bhatkhande also published several ancient music grants whose manuscript he could find during his countrywide tours. Thus, he reprinted and published a number of rare books on music. For example, Swarmil Kalanidhi by Pandit Ramamadhyay, Chaturdandi Prakashika by Pandit Venkat Mukhi, Rag Tirangani by Pandit Lochan, etc., etc. Pandit Bhatkhande wrote so many books in English, Sanskrit, Marathi, Gujarati, and Hindi. But amongst all these books, his series of Hindustani Sangeet Paddhati, Kramik Pustak Malika, has been universally acknowledged as a treasure on an authority of Hindustani ragas, as well as the storehouse of his notation system. One very great work done by Pandit Bhatkhande was bringing about a revolutionary change in the existing system of education. He imparted music education in music institutions, which he especially set up for this purpose. For the systematic teaching of Hindustani music, Pandit Bhatkhande reorganized State Music School of Baroda with the help of Maharaja Syaji Rao Gaikwad, the then Maharaja of Baroda, in 1916. And later on, in 1918, he established Madhav Sangeet Mahavidyalaya in Gwalior with the help of Shri Madhav Rao Sindhya, Maharaja of Gwalior. In 1926, he established Mary's College of Hindustani Music in Lucknow with the help of Rai Umanath Bali and his nephew Rai Rajeshwar Bali, the then Education Minister of United Provinces. Mary's Music College of Lucknow, which was established after the name of Sir William Maris, the then Governor of UP, was popularly known as Bhatkhande College of Hindustani Music. Presently, it is Bhatkhande Music Institute University. Beside Panditji's own institutions, he used to visit and guide very often. There were several other institutions which uniformly followed his syllabus, textbook, notation system, and his method of teaching or system of teaching. As I have mentioned earlier, for teaching in his institutions, Panditji wrote so many practical books in his own notation system, which is popularly known as Bhatkhande Swarlipi Paddhati. Though prior to Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande, his contemporary Pandit Vishnu Digambar Pluskar's notation system had already been developed and was in use to teach Indian music in his own institutions. But with the too many symbols, Pandit Pluska's system had become very complicated. So very soon, this system was replaced by Pandit Bhatkhande's notation system, which brought about a renaissance in Hindustani music. This system is so scientific and easy to understand that it is prevalent till today. Today, Pandit Bhatkhande's system only has become the standard to notate Indian music. Briefing about Pandit Bhatkhande's notation system, Pandit Bhatkhande invented a number of new symbols and brought a vast change in the system of notation. In his notation system, there are symbols for flat and sharp note, that is komal and teevra swar, for lower and upper octaves, that is mantra and tar saptak, for different embellishments like meet, kan and khatka, etc., and for the important beats of rhythmic cycle like sam, tali and khali. I have explained all these symbols in my previous lectures on Bhatkhande's notation system. Not irrelevant to say that Pandit Bhatkhande evolved a very scientific yet a very simple system to notate Indian music. He did not make it complicated by assigning so many symbols. Rather, he used very simple and similar symbols for different purposes, just by putting these symbols over and below the notes. That's why his system is very popular in a very short time. And it is a matter of pride to mention that Pandit Bhatkhande's notation system is prevalent till today. In fact, this system has become the medium of instructions in institutional music education. Another most important change he brought in Hindustani music is in the classification of Indian rags. Prior to Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande, Indian rags used to be classified in rag, ragni and putra paddhiti, that is male, female and children, like a family. Pandit Bhatkhande reclassified rags into currently used thaat system. In fact, Bhatkhande replaced rag ragni and putra paddhati with thaat rag paddhati, which is also known as janak janya paddhati, in which he classified all the rags of Hindustani music under 10 thaats. Pandit Bhatkhande is considered a pioneer of lakshan geets in Hindustani music. He composed several bandishes of lakshan geets in various rags, in which he explained the rags in an easy to understand language. He explained the grammar of rags in the form of geets. For example, lakshan geet of rag bhairavi is bhairavi kahi manmani komal sapsur kar guni gavat pratham pahar ki rani madhyam vadi sur samvadi मध्यमवादी सुर संवादी भक्ति रस की खानी सबको गावत सबको रिझावत भैरवी शास्त्र प्रमाणी. दिस लक्षण गीत इज मेंशन्ड इन पंडित भातखंडेस बुक क्रमिक पुस्तक मालिका पार्ट टू. दिस एक्सप्लेन्स ऑल द ट्रेट्स ऑफ राग भैरवी. पंडित भातखंडेस कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन विल बी इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट मैंशनिंग हिज मोस्ट इंटेलिजेंट and favorite disciple S.N. Ratanjankar, the great musician and educationist himself. Shri Krishan Narayan Ratanjankar's disciple K.G. Ginde, S.E.R. Bhatt, Ramashri Jha Ramrang and Sumiti Mutatkar, among the notable scholars who followed the footsteps of Pandit Bhatkhande. Pandit Bhatkhande suffered paralysis in 1933 and he died in 1936 on the day of Ganesh Chaturthi. To sum up, we can say that as a musician, musicologist, reformist, and above all for systematizing of Hindustani music, Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande occupies an eminent position. Credit goes to him only to establish new Hindustani Sangeet Padhati. The entire world of music was a debt of gratitude to him for his unique contribution. On September 1, 1961, the Post and Telegraph Department of India paid homage to Bhatkhande by releasing a commemorative stamp containing his portrait. In 1966, Indira Kala Sangeet Vishwavidyalaya Khairagarh released a Bhatkhande commemoration volume entitled Bhatkhande Smriti Granth, edited by Shri Prabhakar Narayan Chinchore, to pay homage to Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhatkhande. My special thanks to IKSV Khairagarh for the rare photographs which I have taken from Bhatkhande Smriti Granth. Thank you.